So in the previous class, what we have been discussing, we have been discussing the insertion in a single linked list. Insertion, three types of insertions are there. Insertion at the beginning, insertion at the middle, insertion at the end. So previously we discussed, but due to lack of some diagrammatic approach, some people told they can't under, they were unable to understand. Okay, now in this class I will cover all these three insertions with diagrams so that you can understand, and in the also the deletion with diagram so you can easily understand the program. But as a whole, you must practice on your own, considering each diagram and program. You have to keep the program side by side, and you have to practice on your own. Unless you do that one, you can't understand anything. Okay, and also I shared some lab programs. You can practice them. You can practice that lab programs. You can practice the lab programs online, so that you can understand the techniques which we use in data structures. Unless you practice that lab programs or the programs which I have given, which I shared in unit 1 and unit 2, you will not understand anything. You have to practice the programs. You have to practice the diagrams. Then only you will understand. Okay. So you can see here. So now see, insertion at the beginning. So for example, this is the linked list. For example, this is the linked list. For example, so this one. So you can see here. So in the first thing, head is equal to some 400. You can see here. So you can see a new node was created. The value in that new node is 2. So you can see the diagram. Struct node star pointer int item. Pointer is equal to struct node star malloc of size of struct node star. That means what will happen? I told malloc means allocate. malloc, allocate. Allocate some memory size. Allocate some memory. How much memory? The memory needed for struct node star, that is pointer to a node pointer. So that much malloc allocate some size. How much size? If I write malloc in brackets int, for example, something I have written, you can see here. If I write something malloc, size of int, or suppose, if I write like this, then what will happen? For integer, 2 bytes will be allocated general. So malloc size of int means 2 bytes will be memory will be allocated, for suppose. So in the same way, if I write malloc size of struct node, so node means what? A data point, a data value, and a pointer value. So data value and an address part. Previously I told, you can see here. Each node contains two parts. One is, one is data and another is next. So it is the value of the address pointing to the next node. So you can see this one. Now you can see. You can see here. Okay. Now you can see here. So you can see here, pointer is equal to struct node star malloc of size of node. So what will happen? Malloc means a node was created and the address was stored in PTR. PTR is equal to struct node star. So if the address of this new node is stored in PTR. So what I can write here, new node is equal to PTR. Okay, 1 minute, I will write. Is equal to. PTR is nothing but new node is equal to PTR. So PTR contains the value of 546. So a new node was created, the address is 546. That 546 is stored in PTR. Okay, now you can see. Now the starting node is 3, initial in the linked list. Now I want to add the node 2 for the first of the linked list. So you can see here. So you can see here. So if pointer is equal to null, so you can see here, pointer is equal to null, what I am writing? Point. If pointer is equal to null, printf overflow. If pointer is equal to null, printf overflow. Else, enter value. Now I am want to enter the value. So if pointer is equal to null means what? Now previously it is pointer is equal to 546. Generally, if I want to add, a node is created and it is 546. If no memory is available in the memory, so then what will be the answer? Pointer is equal to null. That means no value is available in the point in the memory. So I will get pointer is equal to null. Then that means what? Point overflow. It's not like that. Some memory is there somewhere at 546 location. Some memory is there. Now I want to insert the value. So you can see. So printf, enter the value, scanf item. See, now PTR of data is equal to item. So in the data part, I am keeping the item value. So what is that item value? 2. I am keeping here. Now in the same way, you can see here in the next. Pointer of next is equal to head. Now pointer of next is equal to head because, see here. Now you have to see this one. So previously, pointer is equal to 546. Head is equal to 400. Now this will, node 2 will become the first node in the linked list and the head will be pointing to this node 2. So what should be the address that should be stored in head? Head 546 should be stored in the head. So I will write like this. So head is equal to pointer of next. 1 minute. Head is equal to pointer. 1 minute. Head is equal to pointer. Pointer value, what is there? 546. I've been copying to here. 546. So if I copy 546, then what will happen? The head is equal to 546 means what? Automatically, this two node will become the first node. Now, again, what I have to do in this two node, in the next part, that is the address part of this node, I should put the value of this one, head of next. Head of next is nothing but head value. I should keep the head value. Previously head is 400. That value should I should keep in this pointer of next. So you can see here. So you can see pointer of next is equal to head. Pointer of next means what? This is pointer actually. This is pointer. Pointer of next means what? In this part. In this part, what I should keep? I should keep the value of head. Initial head, what is the value of head initially? It is 400. It is 400. Initially, it is 400. So if I keep here in this value, if I keep this value, 1 minute. So 400. So if I keep like this, then what I will be doing, this 2 will be linked to 3 because in this address part I have kept 4. 4 is the address of node 3. So if I write, if I keep this one, that is pointer of next is equal to head. Initial head is equal to 400. Then what will be happening? It will be linked. Now next what I have to do, I have to change the value of head. Head is nothing but the address of the first node. So now this 2 node has become the first node. So what I should do, I should keep the value 546 in head. So what I should do, so you can write, see here. I will copy this 546 to head. That means head is equal to pointer. So you can see here, head is equal to pointer. Head is equal to pointer means what? This 546 will be copied. So you can see, so head is equal to pointer. Previously head is equal to 400. Now it should become 546. So I should write head is equal to PTR. So now it will become 546. If it becomes head is equal to 546, if head is equal to 546, then means what? It will be pointing to the node 2 because the address of node is 546. And this will be in this address part, what will be there? 400 will be there. That means it will be pointing to the next node 3. So automatically this will become the first node. So I think all of you have understood. Okay. Now we will see the next. That is adding at the end. Adding at the end. Now I will be adding at the end. So you can see here. So here, two things we have seen. I change, first I created the node, and second step is I store the value of that node in PTR. Third step is in PTR of next, in the address part of node 2, I store the address of head, that is head pointing to first node. So this link I have done. Next what I have done, I store the value of PTR in head. So four transactions I have done. So that's the thing. What you have to do is you have to practice that diagram. Keep side by side. You have to keep the diagram side by side, and you have to decode the program side by side. Then only you can understand. Okay. Now, I will be inserting at the last. For inserting at the last, you can see here now. So inserting at the last. So insertion at the last means what? So see, initially the last node is this one, 100 node. The address part will be null. Because the last null means what? There is no link further. So it will become the last node. So now what I have to do to insert an item at the last. So you can see here, struct node star, PTR, temp. These are same, malloc same. If PTR is on workflow, null, next. Next part C. Scanf PTR. So PTR of data is equal to item. So if I write like this, in this all the steps, what will become? A new node is created. In that new node, some value is stored. That is 102 is stored. Okay. Okay. So 102 is stored. if I do ptr is equal struct node and ptr scanf and ptr of data is equal to item, all is this thing 102 will be stored in the node. Next, see, if head is equal to null, ptr of next is equal to null, head is equal to pointer, printf. If head is equal to null means what? There is no node in the, there is no, absolutely no node in the linked list. Then what, which will be the, what will become the linked list? Then present node which I am adding will become the linked list. So here you can write pointer of next. Pointer of next means what? The pointer pointing to the present node. In that next part, null will be stored. Next, head is equal to pointer. Head is equal to pointer. That is, head will become the pointer. That is, address of the new node created is kept in head. So the head is pointing to the sole node that was created. So only one node is there. Then this part, this if will be there. This if will be executed. So another, if it is not the case, so some nodes are there. So then what I will do, see here, temp is equal to head. I temporarily stored head in temp. Next, see, while temp of next not equal to null, temp is equal to temp of next. So you can see here. So first, what I will do, somewhere here, temp is equal to head. Head means what? The starting address of the node, starting node. So there I will start. There I will start. So there I will start. And temp of next, while temp of next not equal to null, temp is equal to temp of next. You can see here. Temp is equal to temp of next means what? Temp is equal to temp of next means what? See here, for example, see here 96 is the value. In the next, next means this one, this part is known as next, okay? See, next means this part. Next means this part. So for example, temp is at this part. For example, temp is this. For suppose, so temp is equal to temp of next. In temp of next, what is their address of the 100 value? So initially, in temp, the address of 96 is there. If I write temp is equal to temp of next, then what will become? Temp will store the address of 100. And again, at this 100, if I write temp is equal to temp of next, in this address part, the next value which was there will be stored in temp. So starting from the first node to travel from the, starting from the first node to last node, what I will be writing? Temp is equal to temp of next. If I write like this, temp means what? For example, it is pointing to one node. In this, the address part is there. So temp is equal to temp of next. Initially, temp, in temp, what will be their value? Some, for example, some 100 is there. This is the address location. So, is equal to 100. So 101 is the address of this, for example, this SMS node, some 96 node. It is stored in temp 1001. Now, for example, see, the address of 1002. You can see in previous node. So for example, if I write temp is equal temp of next, then what will become automatically? Temp is equal to 1002. So temp is equal to 1002. So automatically, if I write temp is equal temp of next, automatically this temp is changed from 1001 to 1002. So I will be traveling from this node to this node. So how I will travel until temp of next is not equal to null? So you can see here. So I will start at the first node. So you can see here. Temp is equal to head. Head means what? The starting address of the starting node. While temp of next not equal to null, temp is equal to temp of next. So starting from the first node, I will be traveling to the last node until null is encountered. Where will be null will be encountered? You can see in the diagram. See here, null. This slash means null. This slash means null. So null, where will be it will be encountered? When I got the last node, there I will stop. There I will stop. So what will happen? 1 minute. So at this point, what will happen is, while traveling from the first node, I will end at the ended last node. So what will happen? So 1002. So you can see here. Now, after this iteration, so if I write like this, something like this, while temp of next not equal to temp is equal to temp of next, in this iterations, I will, in this whole while loop, at the end of this while loop, I will be at the last node of the list. So in this diagram, what you can see here, the last node is some 102 something, 100 or something, 106 something, 106. So last node, here I will end. Now you can see, The last node is the node which I want to add is will be pointed by pointer ptr. Okay. You can see here. So the node which I want to add, just I created by using malloc. And it is pointed by PTR. And the second step is I started from head, that is first node in the linked list. I traveled and I ended here at the last node in the present linked list. Now I have to add the node which I created to the last of this linked list. What I will do, see here, you can see. In this temp of next, I will keep pointer. Pointer means what? Pointer is the address of this node. If I keep this address of this node in temp of next, automatically it will be linked. And second step is this PTR of next is null. If I keep like that, automatically this will become the last node in the linked list. So I think you have understood. Only one step. See, one thing is first I created a node. Second step is I started from the first node traveling and I ended with the last node. Here at the last node. Last node is equal to temp is at the last node. Now, next what I'm doing? Temp of next. In temp of next, I am keeping PTR value. So in temp of next, if I keep PTR value, then automatically this node 106 will 100 will be linked to 102. In 102, I will keep in the address part, I will keep null. So you can see here, temp of next is equal to PTR, PTR of next is equal to null. So automatically, this will be, that will become the node which I created now will become the last node in the linked list. So last node in the linked list means what? I have added the node to the last of the present linked list. Okay. So that's it. That's over. So I think most of you have understood. If you can't understand, also I can't do anything because you have to practice on your own. So you have to take the diagram just like what I have written, what I am showing. You have to take the diagram, see the how temp value is changing, how the head value is changing, how the next value is changing. All you have to what we call point by point. You have to connect. You have to practice. Then only first you practice the diagram, then you practice the program, then you practice the execution of the program. If you do these two steps only, you can understand the things. Okay. Next. So this was over. So two steps were over. Starting at adding at the start of the linked list, adding at the end of the linked list. Okay. Now you can see. Now I want to add in between the two nodes of the linked list. So see here, you can see here. Between 20 and 40, I have to add 30. Between 20 and 40, I have to add 30. So what are the steps I have to do? In the address part of the 20, I have to keep 30. In the address part of 30, I have to keep 40. Then automatically this will be linked. So first I have to create a node, keep the value 30 there. And next I have to travel from the starting node until the locations, that is third node or fourth node. After fourth node, I have to add. After fifth node, I have to add. Something like that. I have to add. So I will, first node I will start and end here. Something after, for example, 20 is the second node. I will end here. From here, I have to change the addresses. If I change the address of these two, the 20th node address part and 30 address part, if I change, automatically it will be inserted in between these two nodes. So you can see here. So what will, so random insert, all these are same, all this you can know. Int I, loc is the new variable which I am using. Loc is nothing but the location where I want to insert. Next item, struct node star pointer, star temp pointer, mlock size. So all this, all these steps are nothing but creating a node. So next, printf enter element value item. So all these steps up to this is nothing up to all these steps until here is nothing but the creating a node, creating a new node. Next, enter the location after which you want to insert. So scanner percentage d loc. Next, temp is equal to head. The starting node address is stored in temp, temporary variable. So next, for I is equal to 0, I less than loc, I plus plus. Temp is equal to temp of next. So what I will be doing? I will be starting at the starting address of the node linked list. I am traveling from the starting node until where I will be traveling? Some second location means up to, for example, location five. That means after fifth node, I have to insert. Until then, I am writing temp is equal to temp of next. So what will happen? I will be starting from the first node and I will be traveling. So for example, initially, temp is equal to head. That means what? Address of the starting node. So temp is equal to temp of next means what? Automatically, I will be traveling like this. Next. So you can see here. Where I will end? At the fourth location. For example, at fourth location, I will be ending. So you can see that loop for I is equal to 0, I less than LOC, you can see here. For I is equal to 0, I less than LOC, location 4, less than location 4. So you can see here. So for suppose I will be ending here. So after fourth location, so for at fourth location 20 is there. So what will happen? For example, so after that for loop, I will end here. Temp is equal to 498. 498 is address of 20. Now what I should do in this address part, that is temp of next, in temp of next, what I should keep? Pointer. What I should keep? Pointer. You can see. You can see. So new node is equal to pointer. So what I should do now, first I created the node. Second, I traveled from the first node to the location where I want to insert the node. Here, two steps I told. What I have to do? In temp of next, I should write PTR. I should copy PTR. So temp of next is equal to PTR. And PTR of next is equal to temp of next. In temp of next, initially, what is there? The address of location 40. The address of node 40 is there initial here. So for example, I think you are going to write. For example, 565. So initially 564. Initially 564. So initially it will be like this. This 564, the in this address bar, the address of 40 is there. That is 564 is there. Now what I have to do, see here. I should keep the value of 30. For example, in this 30, the address is that something like this. 690 is the address. So initially 564 is there. Now what I have to change, in place of 564, I have to keep 678 because it should be linked in between. And what other thing I should do in the temp of next, what is the value? 564 is the value that I should keep in the pointer of next. So point first, what I have to do in pointer of next, I should keep temp of next. Temp of next means what? 564. So here, what will be writing? I am writing 564. So you can see here. So in pointer of next, I will be copying temp of next. In temp of next, what's the value? 564. I will be copying there. Next, what I'm doing? In temp of next, I will be copying the value of pointer, that is 678 initially. It was 564. Now it will become 678. So you can see. In temp, in pointer of next, I have kept the value of temp. So you can see here. In pointer of next, I have written temp of next. I have written temp of next. In temp of next, I have written pointer. So you can see here, two steps. So changing the, it is nothing, what I have told, insertion or deletion is nothing but just changing the links, I have written, previously told. Okay, that's the thing. Six seventy-eight. Here 564. Okay. 1 minute. Mohini. So you have understood, I think. You have understood here. So changing the links. So tempo of next, I kept in tempo of next, I kept the value of pointer of next. In pointer of next, what is the value? 564. So that value I kept in here. And in pointer of next, what I have kept? Tempo of next. Tempo of next is nothing but 564. So that you can do. Now, insertions are over. Three insertions are over. Okay. Insertions are over. Now, deletion. Deletion at the starting node and deletion at the ending node. So this is the part. So you can see here. So main step is this one. For I is equal to 0, I less than I was I plus plus. I am traveling from first node until the node where I want to insert that location. Until the location, I will be traveling. After getting the location, what I'm doing? These two steps are needed. Pointer of next is equal to tempo of next, and tempo of next is equal to pointer. Okay, these two steps are important. So that's over. Now, deleting at the starting node, deleting at the starting point, deleting at the ending point. That I have to tell. Okay, so you can see here. And this is so here, for example, see, this is the linked list. Head means what? This is the pointer which stores the value of the first node. Now, if I want to delete this one, what I should do? I should enter the value of this address part in the first node to the head value. That is, if I write like this, head is equal to one of next, then automatically what will happen? So for example, you can see. See, if head is equal to null means what? No, there is no head means what? Starting address of the node in the linked list. If it is equal to null means what? There is no node to delete. So automatically list is empty. Else. So what I'm writing, see here. Pointer is equal to head. PTR is equal to head. Head is equal to PTR of next. So you can write here. So you can see here. These two steps. Pointer is PTR is equal to head. Head is equal to PTR of next. So here we can see. Or in one word, I can write like this. If I write like this, head is equal to head of next. So if I write like this, head is equal to head of next. So automatically with what will become head is nothing. Now the value of head is the address of the second node. Then automatically this will become the starting address of the linked list, because head is the address of the starting node. So that is the thing he has. In this way I can write, or he has done what he has done. See, he created a pointer initially. Pointer is equal to head. Head is equal to pointer of next. So pointer of next, he copied to head. Anyway, the meaning is head is equal to head of next. So, and again, what he has done? Free pointer. Free pointer means what? For suppose there is this node is there. Now I linked the head to the second node in the linked list. That is, this will become the starting node of the linked list. Now, that means what? This is of no use. If I all some memory location is already allocated. Now this memory is of no use. So what I have to do? I have to free this memory. If I write like this, free pointer. So if I write like something like that, free pointer. So automatically, what will happen? The address that was shown by pointer PTR will be freed. So what I can tell is it's free PTR is nothing but a reverse of malloc. In malloc, I will be allocating some address. I will be allocating some memory, and the address was stored of that memory location in PTR. Whereas in free PTR, I will be deallocating. So in one word, what I can tell is free means deallocating. Whereas malloc, allocating some memory, deallocating some memory. We use malloc to allocate some memory for the new node which I want to create, and deallocate I will use to free the memory that was deleted. Okay, deallocating. So free and malloc, these two functions are opposite. Opposite, they are having some opposite meaning. Free is nothing but deallocating. Malloc means allocating. Okay. So that's all. So now see. Now that's over. Now I want to delete the last node. You can see here. So I have to delete the last node. So what I have to do, I have to start from the first node, come to the last node, and until where I have to travel? Until the last node where the address part is null. Up to there I have to travel, and I have to delete this last node. That means what? In the last but one node, for example, node 3 is the last node. What I have to do, in the node 2's address part, generally, what will happen in node 2 address part? What will be there? The address of node 3 will be there. But what I will do in node 2 address part, I will keep null. If I keep null, then automatically this link will be broken. So this link will be broken. This link will be broken. I want to break this one. So what I should do? I should keep here. I should keep here null. So automatically the link will be broken. Okay. So to do that one, what I should do? I should travel from the first node to the last node. So here, see, struct node last delete, struct node star pointer one, head is equal to null. If head is equal to null means what? There is no linked list. Head is equal to null means the starting head means what? The starting address of the node of the linked list, it is null. That means there is no node in the linked list. So automatically list is empty. Else it is not empty. Next, what will happen? Head of next is equal to null. Head of next is equal to null means what? Head of next is equal to null means there is only one node in the whole linked list. That's the thing. No, head of next is equal to null means what? If head is pointing to some value and head of next is equal to null means it is nothing but there is only one node. I will delete that one. Head is equal to null, free of head, then it will be deleted. It's not like that. Now I want to delete at the end. So here you can see PTR is equal to head, while PTR of next not equal to null, PTR one is equal to PTR, PTR is equal to PTR of next. So here what I will be doing, I will be traveling here also. I will be traveling from the first node. I will be traveling here. So you can see here. So this is head. I will start from here and I will end at the last node. So here, So you can see here. You can see here. So this is the head. I start here. I am while head of while pointer of pointer is equal to pointer of next not equal to null. I will be traveling until where I will be traveling. You can see here. You can see the what we call it. So here. Else pointer is equal to head while pointer of next not equal to null. PTR is equal to PTR. PTR is equal to PTR of next. I am temporarily storing the pointer PTR value in PTR of 1. Why I will tell. So here I will be traveling until where PTR of next is equal to not equal to null. So if you see the diagram here, you can see here. So I started here at the first node and I have traveled to this node, from this node to this node. While PTR not equal to null, now PTR is equal to null because this is the last node in the linked list. I have reached here. So I will stop here because PTR of next is equal to null. I will stop here. Next, what I will do? See here. PTR is pointing to the last node. PTR of one is pointing to the last but one node. So what I will do? In PTR 1 of next, if I keep null value, then automatically this link will be broken. And if I free PTR, that is the memory allocated by the pointer PTR that was pointing by PTR, we have to free this one. I am deleting means what? I will first deleting means breaking the link and freeing the memory allocated to that node. Deleting a node means two steps. One is breaking the link. Second one is freeing the memory allocated. So you can see here. So first what I will do, PTR of one is equal to null. PTR of next is equal to null. Previously PTR of next is equal to PTR. PTR is there. This value, node three value is stored in this address part. If I keep in this address part some null, for example, if I keep null. If I keep null, then what will happen? Automatically, this will be broken. This link will be broken. Next, what I will do? Free PTR. That means all this memory will be deallocated. Okay, automatically deallocated. That is the thing. Now deleting a particular node. Now I want to delete. You can see the diagram here. So you can see that. So you can see some node one, some node three. I want to delete this node two. So then what I have to come after this location of node one, I have to keep the value of node two of next in. That is, I have to, previously in node one address part, the address of node two is there. Now what I have to do in this node one address part, I have to keep the address of node three. Then automatically this link will be broken. So previously I told deleting means breaking the link. Second one, deallocating the value. So I, instead of node one pointing to node two, if I store the node 3 value in node 1, automatically this link will be broken. So you can see here. So here also, struct node star PTR, star PTR1. Two pointers I am taking. and starting from I is equal to 0, I less than LOC I plus plus, I will be traveling from the first node to the last node. So here you can see PTR F is equal to head. So same thing, PTR of 1 is equal to PTR. PTR is equal to PTR of next. So I will be traveling from the first node until last but one node. So you can, I will stop there. But previously you can see, in the previous example, I am deleting the last node. There, this for loop is not there. There, while PTR of next not equal to null, that while loop is there, because I want to know the last node. But here, I want to know the location where I want to insert. That's why I am using for loop. For I is equal to 0, I less than LOC, I plus plus. So at a location, after fourth location or fifth location, I want to enter the value, delete the node. After fifth node, for example, fifth node I want to enter, I want to delete. So at fifth node, I will stop and I will delete the node. So you can see here. So what will happen? For example, see here. So while traveling from the first node, if I write like this, so while traveling, what will happen? I will end here at fifth location. I want to, 1 minute. I want to delete. So what will happen? This will happen. So you can see here. So pointer is pointing to node one. Pointer one is pointing to node two. So what I have to do in pointer of next, if I keep this pointer one of next, then automatically node 3 address will be stored in node 1. So you can see here, 1 minute. Yes, that's what. Or you can see here. See, point one. So you can see. This pointer is pointing to the node which I want to delete. Pointer one is pointing to the previous node, which I want to delete. So this node one, I don't want to delete. Node two, I want to delete. This is pointed by pointer PTR. And the previous node two, this node two, this node one is nothing but PTR one. So you can see here. So now what I have to do, I have to link the PTR of next to node three. So node 3 address, where it is stored? In node 2 address part. How I can know that value? PTR of next. PTR of next is nothing but the address of node 3. So that I will store in PTR 1 of next. So PTR of 1 of next, previously node 3 value is there. Now I will store, previously node 2 value is there. Now I will store node 3 value. What is node 3 value? PTR of next will give the node 3 value that you can see here. So that's the link. So you can see PTR of next, this is the main thing you have to understand. PTR one of next is equal to PTR of next. Automatically that node two will be bypassed. That link will be broken. Next, what I'm doing, free PTR. So free PTR means deallocate the memory allocated by PTR. So you can see here. Deallocate the memory allocated by PTR. Okay, so automatically that will be done. So this is a random deletion, that is deleting a node in between any two nodes. So by this we have completed three deletions: deletion at the beginning, deletion at the ending, deletion in between two nodes. And insertion also we have completed: insertion at the beginning, insertion at the last, insertion at the middle. So three things. And display, and another function is there, display, that you, I think all of you know, that's the nothing. I will start at the first node and I'll form the first node. I will move to the last node. In between one, I will be displaying the nodes. That's the thing. So that's nothing but a loop. So to display the nodes in the linked list, just I will start from the first node, that is node one, head is equal to head of next, print the item. And again, head is going to head of next, print the next item like that. I will be moving onto the last node. Okay. So that is nothing. So that is the display function. So main thing is insertion and deletion are the main things you have to learn. Really, display is nothing, it's a simple function, okay? So by this one, by the 7 functions, I have completed the single linked list operations. Now what you have to do is, you have to practice on your own, okay? Anyway, I will be sharing all these programs with you so that you can share, you can practice at your home, okay? So I will end today this session. One thing, you have to practice first graphically. Second, you have to practice programmatically, program line by line. Third step, you have to practice on the system. Then only you will have a command on this, what will a programming language. Programming language, whether you write a theory exam or not, the main thing is you have to know the program. If you understand the logic behind that program only, you can write the theory exam also. So practicing the program is the main thing you have to understand.